Today, we will be learning about the work of Michelangelo. You might recognize this artist's name, not because he is one of the Mutant Ninja Turtle characters, but because he was a very famous Italian artist. Michelangelo was born in Caprese, Italy, in 1475, during the Renaissance period, a period of time after the Middle Ages in which Europeans were taking a great interest in the classical arts and sciences from ancient Rome and Greece. Michelangelo was considered to be a true Renaissance artist because he excelled in many arts, sculpture, poetry, painting, and architecture. He didn't limit himself to just one form of art, and he worked hard to master them all. Today, we are going to learn about the painting that Michelangelo did on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel at the Vatican in Rome, Italy. This is not just a story of a very big painting. This is a story of trying new things, going out of your comfort zone, and not giving up. Let's start at the beginning. In 1508, Pope Julius II approached Michelangelo and said that he wanted the artist to paint 12 characters from the Bible on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. Michelangelo said to the Pope, "But I'm a sculptor, I'm not a painter," and pointed to his famous sculpture of David, a character from the biblical story David and Goliath. Pope Julius said, "Well, too bad. I want you to paint the ceiling, and I think you can learn how." Michelangelo thought about it for a while and said, "Okay, I'll do it, but instead of just painting the simple design of 12 characters that you want me to paint, I am going to paint the entire ceiling, over 5,000 square feet, and there will be over 300 characters painted." First, Michelangelo planned out his painting and sketched it out on paper. He had decided to paint the many stories from the book of Genesis in the Christian Bible. Next, Michelangelo had to figure out how to paint the very tall 70-foot ceiling. So he built wooden scaffolding, which resembled tall tower-like structures that he could climb up on top of. Then he had to figure out how to paint in a manner that would make the paintings permanent. He had someone teach him a method called fresco, in which you mix sand and lime into a paste, spread it over the wall, and then quickly add colors before the paste dries. Can you imagine doing this method upside down on a ceiling that is bigger than a school gymnasium? I can't. Some people say that Michelangelo painted the ceiling while lying on his back. Michelangelo himself described himself painting while standing up on the scaffolding and reaching up over his head with his tools. Maybe he did both. Regardless, it was very hard work and it took a toll on his body. But Michelangelo didn't give up, even when he discovered mold growing on the fresco. He insisted on working by himself and making the ceiling just right. After 4 years of very hard work, the ceiling was completed. Hundreds of people pass through the Sistine Chapel every day and stare up at the amazing ceiling. Perhaps you or your parents have seen it. It is truly a historic and awe-inspiring work of art. Today, you will create your own Michelangelo-inspired piece of artwork by taping a piece of paper to the bottom of your desk and drawing a simple story while lying on your back. Let's get started. Step 1. Choose an experience or an adventure that you had over the summer break. Step 2. On one side of your paper, using your own pencil, sketch out a quick design of what you would like to draw. Step 3. After you have planned out your drawing, flip your piece of paper over and ask a volunteer for two pieces of tape. Step 4. Tape your paper to the bottom of your desk. If you do not have access to a short table or desk, or if you are wearing clothing that is difficult to lie down in, you can choose to tape your paper up high on a cabinet or wall so you can still experience what it is like to draw on a ceiling-like surface. Step 5. Choose a few markers and draw your picture on the paper while lying upside down. Remember that this project is not about creating a super detailed or perfect work of art. Rather, this project allows you to experience what it must have been like to be Michelangelo and figure out how to create art on an upside-down canvas. Step 6. After you have completed your drawing, remove it carefully from your table, peel off the tape, and sign your work of art. Final step, add a sticky label to the back of your drawing and write your name on the label. Thank you for creating your own Michelangelo-inspired drawing today. We hope you enjoyed the experience of creating art on an upside-down surface.